Hi, it's Nicholas from 1H23. Today I'm going to show you a system that did poll in US combining a bead filter with a skimmer for seafood purpose. So for example, saltwater recirculated system or for seafood holding system. So just hear him. He tells much better than me without a French accent. Ciao.
I just want to go over the anatomy of this whole thing. We could talk about where the valves need to be placed for optimal operation of this skid system, okay? So, water is being pulled from a sump pump here, this. Return water from the bead filter is coming back here. Return water from the protein skimmer is right here, okay? So let's go around to the other side and take a look at how this plumbing is set up, okay? All right, so we've got a half horsepower water pump here. We are restricting flow into the bead filter so that we can send a portion of the flow through the protein skimmer, okay? Now, we open this valve up and keep this valve open all the time. We restrict this flow here to have a portion of the water going through the bead filter and then another portion of the water going into the protein skimmer, okay? So, water is then split here at the bottom. There's a T. 70% of the water goes here, 30% of the water goes here. We leave this valve open all the time. This water is running downward through what we call a venturi. And that's exactly the point at which air is injected. Air is being sucked in through this port. That creates bubbles that are then injected into this column here. The 30% of water that's coming through this way is adding dirty water where the bubbles are going to be catching that dirty water and then flowing upwards. You see here, that bubbling is happening right now. Now this is a clean water situation, but the more proteins you have in the water, the more feed, the more poop, you're gonna have a lot of foaming out of the top, okay? So, a cool setup with this particular protein skimmer is we've got a drain right here. We've also got a spray bar at the top that will wash all of the foam that collects up in that column, and then that will drain downward into here. So it's simply opening this valve here, and then allowing that spray bar to spray all the solids and then having them drain out to a 5-gallon bucket, okay?